start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through the very heart of it. New York, New York.
Good morning, Mahwah High School. I'm Kyle O'Malley here with Thunder Vision, the Rockefeller edition. On December 15th, Thunder Vision hit the road to highlight one of the greatest tourist attractions of the holiday season, Rockefeller Center. Thunder Vision covered various segments, including One Bite, some very real interviews with Trent Murphy, and Shop Till You Rock. But first, Julia and Rob are going to show us all how to rock. Julia and Rob?
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Dixon and Dixon and all his reindeers pulling on the reins. Bells are ringing, children
sing. Hi, Kyle, I'm Julia Devine.
And I'm Robbie Hinder with Thunder Vision.
And we're here today at the famed Rockefeller Center in New York City to show Mahwah students how to rock.
We created an itinerary to show you what to see and where to go in Rockefeller Center. Let's go.
From Mahwah to the city, it takes roughly about 1 hour and 10 minutes by car, 1 hour 30 by train, and a little over 2 hours by bus. Traffic isn't always when crossing over the George Washington Bridge or going through the Lincoln Tunnel, which are the two most common ways to get to the city. If you drive, parking may cost an arm and a leg.
The first thing you want to see is the Rockefeller Christmas tree. It gets crowded as the day goes on, so you want to get out of the way in the morning. To put the Rockefeller Christmas tree in perspective, the lights stretch 5 miles, and it takes about 45,000 light bulbs to fully decorate the tree. The tree is a 75-foot Norway spruce from the home of Jason Perrin in State College, Pennsylvania. It's 50 feet in diameter and weighs about 12 tons. Putting a Christmas tree up at Rockefeller Center has been a tradition since 1933. The tree stays lit until January 7th, so you have some time to get to cross this off your holiday bucket list.
After seeing the tree, you want to head over to the ice skating rink. The 80th anniversary of the ice skating rink was celebrated last year. It has a capacity of 150 people, and obviously the peak season is between Thanksgiving and New Year's. The rink hours are 8:30 a.m. to midnight. Skate rentals are available inside the skate house, where tickets are sold as well. During the peak season, the cost to skate is $32 per person, $27 on holidays. If you are a child under 11 years old or a senior citizen, tickets are $15. If you need lessons, 30-minute skate lessons are $50.
After skating, head over to NBC Studios. The NBC Tour is a backstage look at the TV network and the studios where many popular shows are taped, such as Late Night with Seth Meyers, Saturday Night Live, The Voice, and The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon. During the week, the studio is open from 8:20 to 2 p.m. On weekends, the studio is open till 5. From the ice skating rink, it is just a short walk across the street. Tours depart every 20 minutes, and they last between 1 to 2 hours. Guests can enjoy behind-the-scenes access to the studios where their favorite NBC programs are taped.
Once the NBC tour is over, Del Frisco's should be where you eat. Del Frisco's is in the heart of New York City's restaurants. This unique American grill features a sweeping bar with a wood-burning oven, expansive walls showcasing over 700 bottles of wine, and a sprawling patio perfect for alfresco dining. At times, there is a high-energy feel of the after-work scene, but at other times, there are guests trying to escape the city rush in the dining room. Reservations are accepted for indoor dining only. Patio seating is available on a first-come, first-served basis. Lunch is served from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Dinner is served from 3 p.m. to 11 p.m.
Towards the end of the day, the window displays can help calm the atmosphere of the New York City rush. There are 8 window displays: Saks Fifth Ave, Macy's, Barney's, Bloomingdale's, Lauren Taylor's, Tiffany & Co., Bergdorf, Goodman, and Henry Bendel.
Now that you know how to rock, make sure you check this off of your holiday bucket list. I'm Julie Devine.
And I'm Robbie Hinder with Thunder Vision.
And we'll see you later.
Yo, Matt.
Yo.
We're going to the city this weekend with Santa to help little kids and give them presents. You want to come?
Nah, man. Wrong guy.
Why not, man? We're helping our little kids.
You've been a naughty, naughty boy!
Claustrophobia impacts children all around the world. If you need help with claustrophobia, please call our hotline down below. I will help you face your fears. Ho, ho, ho.
Hello, love. Trent Murphy here with an absolutely astonishing product right here. We got this one-of-a-kind pencil. Let's get into it. Want to write something down? There you go. Oh, pish posh, I made a mistake. Look at this. We just erase it. Need two? Break it in half? Now you got two. Throw it in the air? Comes right back down. Gravity. Move it back and forth? Now it looks like rubber. Boarding class? Pick it apart? Throw it at your friends. Now do I have a deal for you? For only $49.99, you could get a 12-pack of these, and if that's not good enough, I'll throw in a pencil sharpener for a $25 value. Oh my god, look how freaking sharp that is. Oh my god, look how beautiful this wrote with my doodle. Absolutely astounding. You must buy now and you will get a 12-pack of pencils and a pencil sharpener. And remember to call 1-800-PENCILS-R-US for an absolutely astonishing deal. I'm Trent Murphy, thank you for watching.
Thanks for planning everyone's next trip to Rockefeller, Julian and Rob. But learning how to rock has made me pretty hungry. I guess it's time to take a breakfast, lunch, and dinner break. So let's head down to Jill and John on the street for Thunder Vision's segment, One Bite.
Here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Dixon and all his reindeers pulling on the reins.
Hey Kyle.
Hello Mahwah.
I'm Tom Ricardo's here with Jill Conico at the world famous Rockefeller Center. Today, Jill and I have been traveling around to different food establishments to try their food.
We will be visiting three different restaurants today: the Macchiato Espresso Bar, Little Italy Pizza, and Bill's Barn Burgers. Each of these restaurants have a significant item on your menu that we're going to try and review for you guys. Enjoy!
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
The first stop on One Bite's adventure is to the Macchiato Espresso Bar.
So, we are at the Macchiato Espresso Bar trying the most popular item on their menu, which is their Macchiato Single. It's an espresso with a small amount of foam milk on top.
The Macchiato Espresso was $3.35 compared to Starbucks, which is $4.45.
And we also got these free cookies thanks to Angelica.
And also, I will be trying their famous chocolate chip muffin, which just came out of the oven.
All right, let's see how it tastes.
That's good.
It's really good.
Good stuff.
The second stop on One Bite's trip was to Little Italy's famous pizza.
So we made it to Little Italy's Pizza, where Matt and John are going to try a famous New York slice.
I'll be trying the margarita,
and I'll be trying the buffalo chicken pizza.
One bite, everyone knows the rules.
The final stop on One Bite's journey was to Bill's Bar and Burgers.
Half a mile away from Little Italy's is Bill's Bar and Burgers, an all-American restaurant in the Rockefeller Center.
This burger place was voted top 10 burgers in America by CNN. Today I'm trying the Rock Burger, which is topped with onion rings, barbecue sauce, cheddar and pepper jack cheese, and jalapenos.
Unfortunately, Bill's Bar and Burgers wouldn't let us film John and Jill eating their food, but from what I heard from John, the Rock Burger was delicious.
Wow, I'm stuffed.
Me too. I think my favorite restaurant was Little Italy Pizzeria. How about you, John?
I think mine was Bill's Bar and Burgers. Well, we hope you guys enjoyed us traveling to different restaurants today. That's it from us at One Bite. We'll see you later,
Mom.
Oh my goodness, that burger. Thanks, Jill and John. It's time now to kick back, relax, and have a nice laugh with Thunder Vision's next segment, Very Real Questions with Trent Murphy, who is standing on the streets of Rockefeller Plaza, getting to the bottom of important questions with some random New Yorkers. Good luck, Trent.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Dixon and Dixon and all his reindeers pulling on the reins.
Thanks, Cobb.
Frank Sinatra, New York Yankees, New York Mets, the Giants, the Nets, the Knicks, skyscrapers, dirty water dogs, overly priced items, terrible driving, all the things that make up New York City. We're going to interview people passing by as we navigate these streets and ask them very real questions and see what they have to say. See you soon, Mahwah.
Ho, ho, ho.
Quick question for fellow New Yorker. What's your opinion on Kanye West running for the presidency in 2020?
2020 Kanye. Yeah. I'm all for it.
Rumor has it Michael Scott is trying to be the next manager of the New York Yankees. What do you think about that?
Well, if he can do the job and, you know, if he can do it well and get the team to victory, go for it.
Yeah.
You
seem like you live here. You from around here?
No, originally I'm from Tennessee, but my residence is in Florida.
Really?
Yeah.
It's a lot warmer in Florida.
Yeah.
What are you doing in New York City today?
Oh, just vacationing and just, you know, enjoying the Christmas holiday spirit.
So rumor has it that Eli Manning is being traded to the Jaguars. Do you think this might be their first chance that they actually make the playoffs if he ends up getting traded?
Sorry, no.
Really? You don't think the Jaguars have a shot?
I'm a Patriots fan.
Oh, wow. A Patriot. That was very uncalled for. Rumor has it going around in New York that next year instead of a star at the top of the tree, they're putting a dreidel on the top of the tree. What do you think about that?
Well, trees are a pagan thing anyway, so I feel like they can put whatever they want on the top of the tree, you know?
This is true. Do you celebrate Hanukkah?
No. I celebrate Christmas, but, you know, everybody teach his own.
Yeah. There you go. Donald Trump released the other day that he doesn't plan on putting the tree up next year. What is your opinion on that if it turns out to actually happen?
I would call it fake news if I were you.
Fake news?
Yeah.
Okay. You think that would go on CNN?
I think it'd go wherever it goes.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, excuse me, miss. What's going on over here?
Hi, this is Otto von Schnoodle. Otto doesn't talk. I'm Grace Birch, Otto's mom, and the founder of the Grace Birch Community Alliance. And we travel the United States, and we're now here in chilly New York City.
Michael Scott is trying to be the new New York Yankees manager. What do you think? Do you think that's going to affect the Yankees at all, Michael Scott?
But do you think the team, the Yankees, wants Michael Scott?
You know, he's a great leader. I think that he can really make a difference because the Yankees were so close this year, you know?
They absolutely were, and I watched the World Series. So you know what? I'm going to say go Michael Scott, go Yankees. What do you think?
There you have it.
All right.
So what's your guys' opinion on Kanye West running for president in 2020? Do you think he has any shot at all?
Definitely. Definitely.
Definitely not.
Definitely not. Why do you think not?
I don't know. I wouldn't vote for him.
Why would you not vote for him?
He doesn't really seem to know much about running a country.
Well, I mean, he's a pretty good public speaker with what he did with Taylor Swift at the VMAs, don't you think?
No. I don't think.
Are you a Taylor Swift fan?
She's all right. She's fine. I feel like this is one of those things where they're going to interview us and then we're going to be on the internet and it's going to be, look at these dumb people's answers.
This is not one of those videos. Interviewed some people around the city today. Had a great time. Just looking at this really nice statue right now. Absolutely gorgeous. I'm probably going to have to get her number later. You know, we checked out the tree, learned some new things today, and all around had a great time. So we'll catch you later, Kyle. Back to you.
That was some serious content, Trent. I'm sure it was an honor to meet Otto von Schnoodle. It's now time to get your shopping shoes on with Thundervision segment Shop Till You Rock with Hannah, Jake, and Bella. They will be showing us seasonable shops around Rockefeller. Bella, Hannah, and Jake.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Mixing and mixing and all his reindeers pulling on the reins.
Bella, Jake, and Hannah here with Thundervision at the historic Rockefeller Center in New York City.
While this site is known for its beautiful tree, it is also known for the amount of family activities you can do here.
Exactly, and a big part of the holidays is family. A great way to show love for family is by sharing gifts.
On this segment of Shop Till You Rock, we're going to help you pick out the perfect present for every loved one in your family.
Let's do this.
If you are looking for clothes for the entire family, then Uniqlo is the way to go. The store carries all clothing, including men's, women's, and children's. The Japanese company first opened its doors on U.S. soil, right over the Brooklyn Bridge in Brooklyn, New York City, back in 2006. Since then, many fashion designers joined the Uniqlo team to bring the most fashionable clothing lines to match the intricate American style. Everybody shops at Gap. The largest national retailer operates 2,406 stores nationwide, and today we are on the intersection between 5th and 54th. The store owns brands such as Old Navy, Banana Republic, and Weddington Way. These clothes are the perfect way to show your family love and compassion while also improving their style.
Everyone dancing merrily in the new old-fashioned way. Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can't see. Every couple tries to stop.
When most people hear Urban Outfitters, they think of clothing, of course. But what if I told you their Fifth Avenue location also had a vinyl shop, beauty shop, and separate shoe shop? This versatile shop mixes pure fashion with a hip and modern vibe as it fills up its inventory with stocking stuffers for men, women, and children. Gifts are aplenty here no matter what your taste is, and you will not be disappointed with their selection. We'll be right back.
Thank you for shopping with Thundervision. We hope you have an amazing holiday filled with laughter and love.
I hope we helped you find everything you're looking for. Happy Hanukkah.
Merry Christmas.
I'm Jake.
I'm Bella.
And I'm Hannah. Thundervision signing off. Now back to Kyle.
Well, Mama, that's all from Thundervision's holiday excursion to Rockefeller Center. I'm Kyle O'Malley with Thundervision, and I'll see you later.